want to tell you about a story about black men. Black men in the hood. Devilish men that's involved in the lives of brothers that's being taken. Going all the way back until, like, you know, the slavery days. You know, slavery was a terrible thing, man. And here's a story about some guys, some Lafayette Gardens, some people I grew up with. A whole bunch of black men that came out of the projects, that got involved with drugs, murder, mayhem, criminal activity. And these eventually are what the results turn out to be. I wrote about it in a book I wrote called Mike Tyson Tried to Kill My Daddy. So listen to this. This is a fascinating story.
World's famous Supreme. Team, team, cop. World's famous Supreme. Team, team, cop.
Turned the shock of Zulu the Beast, seeking revenge on everybody that was involved. a nigga named J.R. Post drove to get the weight car. Peanut was the one who Post ordered the hit. Nut friend Homo, brother T-Rock, started bragging the shit. They claimed Kojak passed the gun to the trigger man. Now all of them had to die. It was all part of world plan. The most feared Muslim in New York City. World went to Mecca to find some peace. Lil' Kim became his girl for love and protection. She bought him Jeeps. He was flexing, fly Jews. Alexa, she loved him to death, trying to put him in line. But he was a woman beater, broke the nose a few times. Went on a Wendy Williams show, talk about God. Said Jay-Z was a homo, started pulling his card. Call him Illuminati, part of the Illumination. Feds listening, started investigation. After we're all pilgrimage, the FBI was waiting. Guns drawn, ready to shoot, no hesitation. Had him surrounded with 10 of his clique. Life without parole for doing all those hits.
Unfortunate situation of all of these young black brothers had to die. I don't believe none of them deserved to die. Most of us grew up together, you know, but I want this to be I hope this could be a lesson, you know, for all of us as black men to learn to become brothers in brotherhood and stop taking each other's lives, and, you know, and doing the devilish meant for the people to constantly criticize us as a race, as people. And I just want to give my condolences and may God have mercy on their soul, and I hope they all in heaven and trying to send the spirit back down for us to stop hurting one another. Us to stop killing each other, stop robbing each other, stop downing each other, stop pulling each other down and start picking each other up. Peace, power equality, Allah, see equality.
Hey yo, Deck, man, so tell me the history of this car, man.
16 years it's been laying up, we sweated for it and I sweated to get it back. Niggas thought it was gone. Just cause he dead, that don't mean his car had to go with him. Never that.
Yep, this is history, baby.
This is it right here, baby. You ain't gonna see this car. No color, nothing like it. This is the one that started all the jealousy, the envy.
Yep.
It's all good, though, cause he gonna live through this car. He living through his car. The shit still got his smell in after 16 years. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Right now, I used to be in the passenger seat. Now he in the passenger seat.